We continue now at the top of Daf Kuf Chesam and Bezim Masecha Shabbos. This is Shabbos, Daf 108b. The Mishnah continues, Aval Oso Hu Esmei HaMelech. Even though you're not allowed to make brine on Shabbos, you can make salt water. Now, that seems like a direct contradiction because it seems to be the exact same thing. The Gemara will ask that. Betovel Ben Pito, you can make the salt water and you can dip your, he can dip his bread in it. Venosin Latocha Tavshil, and you can put it into the cooked food. You're allowed to do all of that on Shabbos. Amar Rabbi Yossi says, Valo Hilmi Bein Merubu Vein Mud. What are you talking about? It's going to be salt water. It's brine, whether you make a lot of it or a little. All this will be explained. V'elu hein mei melech hamutarn, and he says, what's considered mutter when it comes to salt water? No sein shemen lechatchila lesoch hamayim. If you put oil beforehand in the water, or lesoch hamelech, or you put the oil into the salt ahead of time, then that's going to be okay. Rashi here says, v'elu hein hamutarn, no sein shemen lesoch hamayim betchila. Kodem sheyitin hamelech, no sein shemen lesoch hamelech. Before you put in the salt, put a little oil in the salt, betchila, in the beginning. Kodem sheyitin hamayim, before you put in the water, the hashemen, Ma'akev, the shemen holds it back a little. Shein hamelech masarav yofa im hamayim. The salt won't mix well with the water. Umatish es kocho mios mei melech azin. It's not going to be strong salt water. Avalo yitin mayim umelech tchila afilo nosin shemen levasof. Don't put the salt in the water in the beginning and then put the oil at the end. Debeshasha nosin mayim umelech yachar. Because at the moment that you put the water and salt together, hunira kema'abid, it appears that like ma'abid, which is tanning. So that's the, now we see the reason of all of this. It's all nira kema'abid. That's why this brine, the salt water, might be a problem. Gemara asks, my Kumar, what's the Tanakhama saying? You're not allowed to make brine, you're allowed to make salt water. What's going on? Amar Rav Yehuda, Amar Shmuel. Rav Yehuda says in the name of Shmuel, Hachi Kumar, here's what it means. Ein osin mei melech merubin. You're not allowed to make an abundance, a lot of salt water. Aval osu mei melech muatan. The Tanakhama holds, you're allowed to make a little bit of salt water. That's the opinion of the Tanakhama. Amar Rav Yossi, Balo Hilmi bein merubin bein muatan. Rabbi Yossi responds, isn't it brine whether it's a lot or a little? So what's he saying? Ibailu, they asked, Rabbi Yossi, lesor or lahatir? Does Rabbi Yossi mean to say they're the same and therefore they're both usur? Or does he mean to say they're the same and therefore they're both mutter? Amar Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Yehuda says, lahatir, he's being lenient, he's saying it's mutter. Midlo katani, Rabbi Yossi, usur, because it never says that Rabbi Yossi says usur. Amar le Rabba, so Rabba responded to him, Hamidaktani seifa ve'eluhein mei melech hamutarim. But the very end of the Mishnah says, Rabbi Yossi identifies for us what's mutter, mechlal de Rabbi Yossi lesser. Doesn't that imply that the first statement Rabbi Yossi made was to say it's usur? Elama Rabba, rather, Rabba says lesser, it really is to say it's usur. Vechein amar Rabbi Yochanan lesser, and Rabbi Yochanan also says that Rabbi Yossi is being machmir, he says it's usur, whether it's a lot or a little. Tanya na amihachu, we have a brisa like this as well. Einosin mei melech merubin lases lesoch hachvashin shebesoch hagistra. You're not allowed to make a lot of salt water to put inside the items you're pickling, which are inside the gistra, which are broken shards, which were used for this purpose. Avalosu mei melech muatin, but you're allowed to make a little bit of salt water. Veochel bahen pito, and use it to eat your bread. Venosin lesoch hatavshlin, put it inside the cooked item. Amar Rabbi Yossi, and Rabbi Yossi responds, V'chim ibnei sha'alolu merubin va'alolu muatan ha'alolu asurin va'alolu mutarn. Because this is a lot and this is a little, so this one is asur and this one's mutar. Yomru malacha merubah asurin malacha muetas mutaris. People are going to say that you can do a lot of, you can do a little malacha on Shabbos, but you can't do a lot of malacha on Shabbos. Ela elu ve'elu asur, and rather Rabbi Yossi says they're both asur. Ve'elu hein mei melech ha'mutarn, and what's considered mutar, no sein shemen umelech or shemen umayim, you put the oil in the salt or the oil in the water, uvelvad shelo yitin mayim umelech lechatchila, as long as you don't put the water and salt together in the first place. So that brisa proves that Rabbi Yossi actually is a strict opinion. Gemara continues at the two dots. Tani Rav Yehuda bar Chaviva, Rav Yehuda bar Chaviva taught, Ein osin mei melech azin. You're not allowed to make strong salt water. My mei melech azin. What is strong salt water? Rabba v'Rav Yosef bar Abba d'Amri Tarvayu. Rabba and Rav Yosef bar Abba both say, Kol shehabeitzat safa behen. It's strong enough that an egg will float in that salt water. V'chama, how much is that? Amar Abaya, Abaya says, Trei tilsi milcha v'tilsa mai. It's going to be 2/3 salt, 1/3 water. Lamaya avdila, what do you make this concoction for? Amar Rabbi Avo says, Lamurai, so it's for the fat. Rashi says, we're talking about the fat of fish. When you are preparing that, you use this kind of strong salt water. Tani Rav Yehuda bar Chaviva, Rav Yehuda bar Chaviva taught, Ein molchin snunu veitza b'Shabbos. You're not allowed to salt a radish or an egg on Shabbos. Rav Chizkiya, Mishmei D'Abaya, Amar, Rav Chizkiya in the name of Abaye says it's a known asur a radish as asur ubeitz muteris an egg is mutter. Amar Rav Nachman, Rav Nachman said meresh have a malach na pugla. In the beginning, I used to salt radishes on Shabbos. I mean, afsudi kam afsidnale. I said I'm really just making, I'm taking away the sharpness, which really makes it worse. So I'm not improving it, so it should be mutter. The Amar Shmuel, because Shmuel said pugla chorfi mali. That when you have radishes which are sharp, that's better. However, kevin to shaman al hadachiyasa ula. But then I heard that which when ula came, the Amar he said b'marava malchi kishri kishri. He said that in the West, they salt piles and piles of these. They clearly think that it does something good. So, mimlech lo malachna, I don't salt it anymore. Tivule vayde matvilna, but I will dip it in salt water. That much I will still allow. Tani, Rav Yehuda bar Chaviva, Rav Yehuda bar Chaviva taught, esrog, tznon uveitza, when it comes to an esrog, a radish, or an egg, il mole kliposan hachitzon, if not for the outer shell, einam yotzim ibnei me'ayim la'olam, they would never leave your insides at all. It would not be easy for you to go to the bathroom after eating it. Rashi says the shell of the egg, really refers to the white part of the egg. They're just calling everything kliposan. Kiyasa Rav Dimi, Amar, when Rav Dimi came, he said, me'olam lo tava gavra biyamid stom. A person never drowned in the Sea of Sodom in what we call the Yam HaMelech. Amar Rav Yosef said, Hafucha Sodom v'hafucha Mila. Sodom was overturned, and the words that this person just said were overturned. Why? Gavra hu delo tava, is he trying to say that a person never drowned Keshura Tava, but would drown, but like you had a boat made out of logs, it would sink? That doesn't make any sense. It's backwards. Amar le Abaye, so Abaye said to Rav Yosef, you're totally misunderstanding what he's saying. Lomi boy kamar, he was saying a lomi boy. Lomi boy kshura da'afilu b'chol meimo shabolam lotav. Of course, things that are made out of wood, they wouldn't drown. If you had beams that are made out of wood, they wouldn't drown anywhere. El afilu gavra da'tava b'chol meimo shabolam b'yamad estom lotav. The whole point was, what Rav Dimi was saying was, even people who drown in other bodies of water, they would not drown in the Yam HaMelech. L'may nafkamina, the Gemara says, what difference does it make that he's identifying how salty the Yam HaMelech is, this Yam of Sodom is? Kiya deravin have a shakel vazel achori derab Yirmiya. It's similar to when Ravin, he was following Rav Yirmiya, aguda diyam de Sodom. He was following him on the banks of the Sea of Sodom. Amar lei sete ma'u l'mimshi mehani maya b'shabbos. Are you allowed to use these waters on Shabbos? The issue is that if you bathe in these waters, they had a certain refuah. They healed a person in his eyes, so because it was the salt water. So he asked, is that a problem of refuah on Shabbos? Amar Leih said, Shaper Dami, it's not a problem, because as Rashi explains, refuah is only asur midrabbanan, and it's only asur if it's clear that you're doing it for refuah purposes. If it's not clear you're doing it for refuah purposes, it's not a problem. The asur midrabbanan is because we're afraid that if people are going to see that you're doing a clear refuah, they're going to come to do shchikas samimonim. They're going to come to grind up and prepare medicines on Shabbos. But then he asked, Ma'u lemeimatzu lemiftach, what about to go into the water and purposely open and close your eyes to try to heal your eyes? Amar Leih said, Demzulo shamati, he says, I didn't hear an answer to this question. However, Kayotze ba shamati, I heard a similar question. The Amar Reb Zeira, because Reb Zeira said, Zimnan Amar le Mishmeid Rav Masna, Zimnan Amar la Mishmeid Marukva. Sometimes he quoted it in the name of Rav Masna, sometimes he quoted it in the name of Marukva, Utravayu Mishmeid Davua de Shmuel Velevi, and both of them, they were quoting it in the name of Avua de Shmuel, of the father of Shmuel and Levi, Amrin, they were both quoting it in their names. Chad Amar, one of those people, either the father of Shmuel or Levi, so one of them said, Yayin besoch ayin usser, to put wine into the eye, that's already a problem because it's clear you're doing it for refuah. Al gav ayin mutter, just to put it on the eye and then memel it causes healing, that's okay. The Chad Amar, and the other one says, Rok tapel, if you have spit, that's tapel, that's free of any flavor. It has no, you had no food in your mouth. Afilo al gav ayin usser, that even to put it near the eye, around the eye, on top of the eye is a problem because then it's disgusting, no one would do that for any other purpose other than healing, so it's obviously clear you're doing it for healing purposes. In any case, the father of Shmuel and Levi, they both made these statements, and it's pretty clear that if you're purposely opening and closing your eyes, it's going to be a problem, because anytime it's clear you're doing it for a refuah of the eye, it's going to be a problem. The Gemara now says, Tistayim davua de Shmuel hu damar yayin besocha ha'ayin aser al gav ha'ayin mutter. Let's try to conclude and prove that it was the father of Shmuel who made the statement about the wine, that in the eye is a problem, on the eye is okay. How do we know that? Midamar Shmuel, shora adam pito b'yeno B'yayin v'nosno agava ayin v'shabbos. Shmuel made the same statement, so probably got it from his father. He said that a person can take some bread and soak it in wine and put it on top of the eye on Shabbos. The Shmuel le'miman, who did he hear it from? Lav the Shmuel le'miavua. He must have heard it from his father. So obviously the father Shmuel is the one that made the statement about the wines. The Gemara says, "V'latayimich." But according to that logic, Hadamar Shmuel roke tapel afila gabai and aser. Shmuel said the same thing when it came to the spit. He said, if you have spit that's free of any flavor of any food, it's aser to put it on top of the eye. So the Shmuel le miman. Who did he hear that from? Ilema the Shmuel le meavu. If he heard it from his father, Ela Levi v'lo Chadamar, then we don't have anything that Levi said. The father of Shmuel made both comments. Ela Chada Shmuel le meavu. Ava Chada Shmuel le meLevi. Obviously, Shmuel heard one statement from his father. He heard the other statement from Levi v'lo Yadina, and we still don't know. Hi meavu, hi meLevi. What he heard from his father? What he heard from Levi? We have no idea who said what, but it doesn't really matter. The point is that the halacha is you can't do it if it's clear that it's for refuah, and so that would be true in the Yam HaMelech as well. Amar Mar Ukva, Amar Shmuel. Mar Ukva said the name of Shmuel. Shora Adam Kilur and Meir of Shabbos. A person can soak plaster for the eye on Erev Shabbos. It was some kind of an ointment they used to heal the eye. Venosnein Al Gav Enof Veshabbos. He can put it on top of Zion Shabbos. Veno Choshesh. It's not a problem. Bar Liyue Havikoi Kameh de Mar Ukva. Now Bar Liyue was standing in front of Mar Ukva. Chazi Adav Amayin Tzu Pasach. He saw that not only was he doing this, he was opening and closing his eye on purpose to get it in. Amar Lei said to him, Kuli Hai Vade Lo Shor Mar Shmuel. Mar Shmuel, even though he might have allowed something, he certainly did not allow that. That's too obvious that you're doing it for refuah. Shalach le Rabbi Yani le Mar Ukva. Rabbi Yani sent Mar Ukva the following message: Lishtar lon mar mehanach chilurin de Mar Shmuel. Can the master please send us some of these chilurin that are used for the eye from Shmuel? We want to use them. Shalach le, he sent them shadurim mishadar nalach. I'm going to send them to you. To lo teimat sar ayin ana. Don't say that I'm stingy. I don't want to act like I'm saying no. But I want to tell you that Shmuel said, Tova tipas sonin shacharis, or rechitas yadayim raglayim becham in arvis. It's better to just use some cold water, a drop of cold water in the morning, and wash your hands and feet in warm water in the evening, mikol kilurin shabolim, better than any of these kilurin, any of these concoctions of plaster that are used. Better to just do that, so they're really not worth anything, but I'll send it to you anyway so you don't think I'm stingy. Tanya Namiach, we have a brisa like this as well. Amar Rabbi Mona Mishum Rabbi Yehuda. Rabbi Mona says in the name of Rabbi Yehuda, Tova tipas sonin shacharis, or rechitas yadayim raglayim arvis. It's better a little bit of cold water in the morning and some warm water for the hands and feet in the evening. Mikol kilurin shabolim, from all the kilurin in the world. Hu haya Omer, he also used to say, Yad la'ayin tixis. If a person's hand touches his eye before he washes netilas yadayim on shacharis, he should cut off the hand. All these things are before netilas yadayim because you have a ruach ra on your hands. So if they touch the eye, yad l'chotim. If the hand touches the nose, tixis, it should be cut off. Yad l'peh, it touches the mouth, tixis, it should be cut off. Yad l'ozen, to the ear, tixis, it should be cut off. Yad l'chasuda, if the hand touches the chasuda. Rashi says that the chasuda is the area of bloodletting. Tixis, then it should be cut off. Yad la'amu, if the hand touches the private area in the front, tixis, it should be cut off. Yad la'pitabas, tixis, if it touches the private area in the back, it should be cut off. Yad, and then the statement continues, and we'll see the continuation of the statement on Daf Kuf Tes Amud Aleph in the next video.